Coming up on this week's news, the IET unveils a new standard for EV chargers to tackle PEN faults. Electric car giant Tesla takes issue with the recent battery storage standard, and an installer says that electrical cables were hanging loose in a Scottish hotel in which three people died in a fire. Welcome to Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Make sure you click the link in the show notes to access their online store. Whether you're listening in the van, on-site, or down at the wholesale counter, I'm Joe Robinson, and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. And if you think you've spotted the two words that I've been challenged to slip into this week's show, comment with them below for the chance to win a prize. The IET has unveiled a standard to regulate the way EV chargers deal with PEN faults. The institution, which writes the wiring regulations, says the document will help installers choose the right kit for the right location. The current regs require chargers to stop powering the vehicle and instead completely isolate it from the charging equipment when a particular fault occurs on the supply cable out in the street. Most manufacturers provide this functionality, but they don't all do it in the same way. This causes confusion for electricians choosing the most suitable equipment and approach to installation. IET 01, as the doc is called, provides a standard way for EV charging equipment to operate when encountering this fault condition. Mark Coles of the IET says that the rising demand for power to charge EVs means that the risk of lost PEN incidents is increasing. And while it's true that PEN faults are trending upwards this year, eFIXX research shows that the number of injuries from PEN faults is actually falling. A Freedom of Information request that we put into the Health and Safety Executive shows that there were no injuries from PEN faults in the last 3 years. The last year in which injuries were recorded, there were just three across the whole UK. There have been 329 reported incidents to the end of August where there was a risk of an injury. This compares to 447 for the whole of last year. The DNO with most broken neutrals this year where there was a risk of injury is Southern Electric Power Distribution with 72 reports. The combined Northern Power Grid regions of Yorkshire and the North East had 77 such incidents. By contrast, in the same period, Scottish and Southern Energy reported just one PEN fault. The IET standard is available to purchase for, brace yourself, £260. I've still put a link in the show notes in case Elon Musk is watching. Meanwhile, Musk's electric car firm Tesla is taking issue with the recent battery storage standard. Publicly available specification 63100 hit the headlines in March when it ruled that electricians should never place battery packs in a loft. It also stated that access to cells and monoblock batteries should be possible only with the use of a tool. Tesla, which makes the Powerwall battery pack, says some of the provisions are of concern to the company. It describes the section of the document on ventilation as unnecessarily broad brush. It says that instead of a blanket requirement for fresh air to outdoors and a minimum 1 meter distance from doors and windows, it should accept Powerwall's compliance with the rigorous UL standards as an alternative. It also says that the requirement for an alarm to alert householders to a failure is not in any product standard. It could also set false performance expectations from a failing pack. Finally, Tesla alerts installers to a discrepancy in impact standards for battery packs mounted in driveways and garages. The specification demands an IK rating of 10 in these locations because of the risk of being hit by a car, but the Tesla Powerwall is only rated to IK 8. So the company says installers should consider other barriers and enclosures in such applications. I've put the link to Tesla's full statement in the show notes. In other news, a CCTV installer has said that electrical cables were hanging loose in a Scottish hotel in which three people died in a fire. Jamie Grierson described the state of the electrical installation at the New County Hotel in Perth during a police interview. He said he was so concerned about the electrical safety of the building that he contacted an electrician friend to ask how often public buildings should be safety checked. Grierson admitted returning to the burnt-out wreckage of the hotel in the wake of the fatal fire to remove a CCTV camera he had installed before the blaze, but he denies breaking in and stealing around 15 surveillance units installed before the triple tragedy in January of last year. The fire claimed the lives of sisters Donna Jantz van Rensburg and Sharon McLean from Aberdeen and Edinburgh man Keith Russell. Experts from the Scottish Fire and Rescue Service are understood to have completed a safety audit on the building the previous month. Scottish newspaper The Courier says that the completed audit raised no fewer than 21 concerns that fire chiefs wanted to see addressed. Among the issues flagged up were deficiencies with the emergency lighting. The experts reported it as being inadequate on some routes and recommended a complete system upgrade. They also said that a competent person should inspect the electrical mains installation within the premises at suitable intervals. It's unclear whether the hotel acted on the fire services report at the time of the inferno. The trial of Grierson continues at Perth Sheriff Court. In product news, Martindale has issued a safety advisory note to electricians over its Drumond MTL 10, 15 and 20 test lamps. The company says it's received reports of an incident where a probe contact spring was found to be missing from one of its MTL 15 models. This missing spring resulted in intermittent contact between the test probe and the LED circuit. When proven with a 690 volt proving unit, the indicator illuminated, but when it was in contact with the 230 volt mains, it did not, leading to a near miss. The company emphasises that many thousands of the products have been sold, and this is the only such incident that has come to light. Martindale says all its stocks of the MTL 15 and MTL 10 and 20 models have been checked and no further instances have been identified. It concludes that this is an isolated incident where either the spring was lost in service or was not fitted at the point of manufacture. The spring ensures reliable contact under varying degrees of pressure and probe angle when in use. The company recommends that installers with a unit from the brand should check that the spring is in place. If it's not present, you shouldn't use the device. Martindale says that all voltage indicators and test lamps should be proved before and after use in accordance with safe isolation procedures. It's good practice to always match the maximum output voltage of the proving unit with the maximum voltage range of the test lamp. I've put the advisory notice as well as the contact details of Martindale technical support in the show notes. A big thanks to our correspondent Sergio Fernandez from Costa del Watford for the heads up on that story. If you stumble across a story you think we might be interested in while you're munching your lunchtime ciabatta, please drop us a line at admin@efix.co.uk and we'll give you a shout out too. And speaking of all things safe isolation, our last question of the week was taken from our free training package on safe isolation made with TIS. The question was, which regulation in the electricity at work regs requires the cutting off and isolation of electricity to prevent danger? And the correct answer is, of course, Regulation 12. A semi-respectable 68% of people got it right on YouTube, while on LinkedIn they lagged behind a little with 62%. Let's see if they can do any better next week. Once again, check out the free training package. You'll find a link in the show notes. Signify, the manufacturer of Philips lighting, has launched a website version of its LumXpert app. The site boasts the most extensive catalogue of both Philips and EcoLink products with immediate availability. There's also 30% discounts available for the trade and up to £10,000 30 days credit. The site has been specially created for electrical installers and it brings together all the necessary tools for day-to-day tasks such as quotes, lighting calcs, ordering and tracking. You can find Philips and EcoLink lighting products by type or application and order from your usual wholesaler. You can compare prices, check stock levels and track your order. There are also special financing options. Additionally, you can create exportable lighting calculations to share with your customers. You can also get help and support on lighting issues. And finally, an office light made from cardboard has won a prestigious award. The OptiClip Terra from major lighting brand Sylvania has triumphed in the Build Back Better Awards for its contribution to sustainability. The company said that transforming cardboard from a packaging material into a robust light fixture posed significant challenges, akin to climbing Mount Kilimanjaro, no doubt, requiring rigorous testing and multiple design iterations. Made in France, the luminaire is folded, not glued, and 100% recyclable. Its instruction sheet is printed directly at the back of the product to reduce the need for paper. It uses two removable LED modules, which means that replacement is simple. The OptiClip Terra has a rated life of 60,000 hours and is guaranteed for 5 years. And our usual reminder that we're in the market for your stories, your projects and your recommendations, as we'd like to share them with the wider eFIXX community. In October, we're focusing on heating and ventilation and commercial solar and battery. Send us pictures of your installs or let us know if you've come across any new kit that's making your job easier. Now, just before we get to your favourite bit of the show, where I reveal last week's challenge words and winners, we want to thank our premium partners. We couldn't make the news without you. First up, it's the people who've created the Swiss Army knife of solar inverters, along with all-weather batteries, very much the Boy Scouts of the solar industry. It's SunSync. Up next, they're resolving ventilation problems one property at a time, offering a simplistic ventilation design service and high-quality products made right here in the UK, breathing fresh air into your home. It's EnviroVent. The best thing to come out of Yorkshire since stainless steel, the home of EV Ultra and other groundbreaking and quality products, it's Doncaster Cables. With an incredible range of equipment from EV charge points through industrial sockets and switches to kit for explosive areas, plus they supplied gear for a Campari factory, so they'll always have a place in my heart. It's Scarmy. Big thanks to you all. We really appreciate your ongoing support for the news. If you think you know the words that I've smuggled into this week's show, pop your guess into the comments. We'll take all those correct guesses and select one at random to be the winner of an eFIXX goodie bag prize. Answers submitted after about lunchtime on the Thursday after release will not be entered into the draw. Now let's reveal the winners of last week's challenge word competition. Last week's words were topiary and herons, and the winner we plucked from our digital hat was David Rayner 4699. So well done to you, David. Make sure you click the Get Involved link in the show notes to claim your prize. Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Remember to click the link in the show notes to check out their online shop. Make sure you subscribe to receive the next update. Thanks for listening, and until next time, have a great week. Stay safe out there, and remember, there's no such thing as a torque calibrated arm.